This is Wrap the News, and first I want to praise God for allowing me to bring the truth in the clearest manner. And next, I want to praise God for everybody who support the truth and support the channel. And the support goes like this. Whatever you sow, you shall reap. And it's just like an apple or an orange seed or a tomato seed that you plant in the ground. It is the same thing. And that's why God has given us the similitude of the plant. When you put it in the ground, it grows up and then it produces more than what you put in there. It was kind of dead and it came to life when you sowed it, you know. And that's how everything works in creation. It works like that. So if you sow evil, it's going to reap an evil tree, an evil fruit, and you ain't gonna like what it reap. But if you sow good and you support the truth, then you're gonna reap good and you're gonna reap more than what you sowed. And I say that three times. You are going to reap more than what you sowed. It ain't no plea for money. It ain't no plea to do this or that. It ain't no promotion for donations. It's the truth. You are going to reap what you sow. You know. And so with that said, I want to kind of like talk what's on my mind. And number one, we got, you know, Iran talking about that they're going to retaliate for what happened, you know, the attack that happened to them, when and how and where, I don't know. And then you got Netanyahu claiming that, okay, we know where all your bombs is and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, pretty much I wouldn't if I was you. And then you got Trump, you know, over there in Iraq, waiting to do a surprise attack on Iran from Iraq, you know what I mean? Pretending like nobody know what the hell this wicked ass is doing, you know. And then you got the White House in a fiasco. It is sickening to watch that, ain't it? I mean, anybody who watching that whole White House ever since his lard ass been up in there, it is just sickening to watch. It has been chaos and fights. You know, it remind me of the hood, man. And that ain't no, it's not a lie. The White House remind me of the damn hood. I mean, the curses is just going all on their asses. You know, and it's, I don't know, it's just sickening to watch. And I don't know how anybody can stomach that. And also, we got strange weather. It's cold, people are freezing to death. I mean, literally just freezing. You was ill-prepared, like you didn't know you was gonna freeze to death. And these people are just freezing to death all over the damn place. They didn't know. You know, it's just like something strange in the air. And the weather is actually colder than what you actually think, you know. And then pole shift, like these people who measure in the earth, I don't know what they're doing. They claiming that the earth is moving, you know, and we're having some kind of pole shift. Like it's slowly just moving. And I noticed that we have in the middle of the desert in winter, green grass growing every damn where, which is crazy. You know, in the winter, it still flies around, which makes no sense. It is freezing cold, you know. And I'm talking about, I looked at the mountain and I was going to film that today and just show it that it was just green all on the mountains and all on the plains. And I'm like, what the hell? Something definitely is changing, you know. And then we got this planet, you know, that's out there. Like this morning I woke up, or yesterday morning at now, it was red at the horizon before the sun came out. I'm talking about burgundy red. And it was just a burgundy glow for a long distance on the horizon in the east all the way to the north and southeast. You know, right there on the horizon to let you know that that thing is right there. And it's affecting people. So people are growing more tired right now, sluggish, dizzy. You know, there's people walking around dizzy. Whoa, I'm dizzy. You know, they don't even know why they dizzy, but this thing is affecting you. And then everybody got to think, you know, what's going to make brother fight against brother and nation fight against nation? Is it the demons? No, I believe that this planet is evil and it's magnetically charged. You know, it's like a electromagnetic charge on this thing. And that affects the mind and the hearts of the people. And since it's a wicked planet and it only comes in during wicked times, like when Sodom and Gomorrah was at the height of their homosexuality, it came in and rained brimstones down on them. And then the same thing, there's all the plagues and everything that happened in Egypt. And the time of Noah when it came in, and it just screws up the weather and everything else. So God had created all of this beforehand, you know, and these systems that we unaware of because we are ignorant people, and I'm talking about everybody, black, white, yellow, green, and brown. We starting to be aware of things that was out there that we didn't know was out there. Maybe the governments knew they was out there and they just keep it from the people, you know. But nevertheless, it is time to stay prayed up. You know, it is time to sow towards the kingdom. You know, sow towards the kingdom. Anything that can get your ass in the kingdom, you need to do it. All your sin, all your sneakiness, you think you're going to hide it from God? He said, your sin is going to be revealed by the fire, man. So you ain't going to hide nothing from God. You know, and you got some military truck, you know, supposedly carrying generators and large amounts of transformers and stuff like that. Like they're going to try to do, when the lights go out, they're going to try to do some emergency lighting or something somewhere, you know. And it's just a bunch of crap, man, happening everywhere, you know. This 5G thing, I refuse to do anything on 5G. You know, I don't even want to talk about it. But I know other people are doing that, and I ain't going to do anything like that. But again, I just like to say that, you know, keep your eyes open, people. Keep your eye on the prize, which is God and the end time and salvation. Don't let anything detour you. Don't do nothing wrong at this particular time. God said when he come, you better be spotless, blameless, spotless, you know. And so you better be, or you're going to pay the consequences, and it's going to be painful. This is Raptor News.